Hello everyone, my name is Steve LaWarre. I'm the Vice President of Horticulture here at Frederick Meijer Gardens and Sculpture Park. And we are celebrating Chrysanthemums and More, which is our annual fall exhibition. And this year we're focusing on autumn glow. So that special way that light changes and that some of those colors just really get enhanced this time of the year. And I wanted to talk with you a little bit about the science of leaf change and how that happens. It's really pretty extraordinary. First thing that I want to talk about a little bit is trees. And most trees that we see around us here are deciduous, which means that they drop their leaves. In fact, deciduous is from the Latin meaning to fall. And this is a river birch branch that I have here in my hand. And when we talk about fall leaf drop, it's important to recognize a couple things with these branches. First of all, is each one of these leaves is attached to the branch by a petiole or a leaf stem. And each one of those attachment points is called a node. So you have a single leaf from the birch that's attached with a petiole to a node on the branch. And the green in these leaves comes from chlorophyll. And chlorophyll is a fancy word for a type of a cell that's within those leaves that gives them that green color. And chlorophyll is responsible for food production. And the fancy word for food production is called photosynthesis. And I always like to remember photosynthesis just as sugar from the sun. So that's how plants produce sugar, which is their food source. And they do that by combining sunlight, the air that's around us, and then water. And those three things, sunlight, air, and water, are producing sugar within the plants by those cells that we call chlorophyll. Well, in the fall, a couple things start to happen. The chlorophyll starts to stop production, it starts to break down, and chlorophyll is water soluble, so it gets absorbed by the plant. And when that green starts to disappear, there's colors that then appear that we think of in the fall as fall color. And colors like yellow and orange have been there all along. So in this birch, for example, a river birch will turn a bright yellow in the fall, and that yellow is already there. And when the chlorophyll starts to degrade and be absorbed by the plant, that yellow is then revealed. Other colors like browns, for example, that you see in a lot of our oak trees, browns are caused by a buildup of tannin, and tannin is something that starts to build up at the end of the summer. And so as that chlorophyll disappears from the leaf, those browns start to be enhanced. And then you have other colors like reds and purples that are formed because of stored and trapped sugars. And a lot of times some of those excess sugars can even become sort of an antifreeze within those leaves and cause that color to last even a little bit longer. So that's why some of those reds and oranges are some of those last colors that we see, you know, on those trees at the very end of the fall color time frame. So as fall continues to, you know, to progress, there's another thing that happens that causes the leaves to drop. That's a single layer of cells that's at the base of that petiole, at the attachment point to the stem. And those cell walls begin to weaken, and then when they become weak enough, the leaf will break off at that single line of cells and the leaves will fall to the ground. And it's just a really extraordinary process that allows plants in northern areas to produce leaves in the spring and summer, and then to reabsorb some of those nutrients, drop those leaves as protection in the winter, and set themselves up for that whole cycle once again the following spring. So I hope you have an opportunity to walk around the grounds, enjoy these changes as they occur this fall, enjoy Chrysanthemums and More, and the autumn glow that you'll experience all around you.